Hello wonderful people, welcome to Crown Melody. If this is your first time coming around, thank you so much for coming. This channel, we do recipes, we talk about faith, we share the word of God, we do lifestyles, we do so many things. We share our life stories to encourage each other, to learn from it, and then to amend our ways before it is too late. Yes, today we are preparing charred omelette, but I also want to appreciate all my returning subscribers. God bless you for the constant support. I so much appreciate you all. Thank you so much, my new subscribers that have joined the family recently. Thank you so much. I so much appreciate you. Okay, thank you. Today we are doing something. We are preparing charred omelette. Yes, this charred omelette, you don't need much. In Spanish, we call it acega, tortilla de acega, which is very delicious, very healthy, that you can eat this as your lunch. You could accompany it with some sliced rice, some potatoes, some plantain. Okay, you can add it to your meal. It's so healthy, you don't need much to be able to prepare this. Yes, someone will say, can you only prepare this with chard or acelga? No, you can prepare this with spinach. Okay, you can prepare this with spinach, anything vegetable and leafy like this. You can use it to prepare this tortilla or this omelette. Okay, anything leafy except the one we have in Ghana, that is a bit sticky, that one you can use it. But anything leafy, you can use it to prepare your omelette. Okay, so I chop the chard or the acelga into pieces, add small water to it, and then add salt. Then I'll go ahead and boil it. Okay, I'll go ahead and boil it, and then the steak, where I've cut off, you can decide to put it in the fridge when you are preparing some soup or anything, or your stew. You can just decide to chop it into pieces to use it. Sometimes here, we boil that and then we stick it into, when you watch that how to fry meluza fish, you see that I prepare some mix up with flour, milk, and egg. You can do it like that and then mix it inside or stick it inside to fry. Okay, yes, but today I'll not be using that. So here, you, after boiling your chard, you have to let it cool down, to cool down completely before you go ahead to do what, to use it. Okay, because if it's hot and you add it to the egg, you know, it will cook on itself and it will not form the omelette that you needed. So you have to wait until it's well cooled down before you use it. Okay, now we are going to use egg. You know, the reason why I always use extra bowl to pat my egg inside before adding is to be sure that I'm not going to spoil my plenty of my eggs with just one spoiled egg. So always make sure you separate your eggs before adding in one big bowl. Okay, that's why I always do it like this. Okay, there was a time it happened to me, I missed a lot of egg and just one spoiled everything. So please always take notice of that. So we'll go ahead and mix this with a bit of salt. Remember, we boiled the chard with salt. So here, you just boil it with, we just mix it with a bit of salt, okay? Some use garlic as well. Some use garlic. One thing, when you're not going to eat this in a day or two, you don't need to add onion. Because when you add onion, it gets spoiled beforehand, okay? So if you want this to be there as long as you are ready to eat it, you are not ready to eat it in a day or two, it's better you do it like that without adding onions, okay? So you go ahead and mix your eggs well. After mixing your eggs, There's something to know I want to say. I know a lot of Ghanaians watch my video. Thank you so much, my Ghanaians brothers and sisters. I so much appreciate you. Thank you so much for watching. People from UK, Italy, Canada, oh my goodness, Germany, a lot of places, India, that I'm so shocked and surprised, and especially Chile. Thank you so much for watching my videos. I so much appreciate it. And if you're a Ghanaian, you can also prepare this with kotombre. Do you know kotombre? You can prepare this with kotombre or boma, the one we used to prepare okra soup. Do you remember that? You can also use it, okay, to prepare it. Now add it to the egg, mix it thoroughly, mix it well, so that you get the egg will, you know, mix with everything with the child, okay? So after mixing it well, let's see what we are going to do next after this. So now our oil is being heated up, okay? So we are going to add it to it, okay? Just a small oil, not much, okay? Even here, like the oil is a bit much, just a teaspoon or tablespoon of oil, tablespoon of oil, 2 tablespoons of oil, okay? And then you just use it to fry your omelette. And sometimes you can even fry this without oil, you know, with the egg. With a good saucepan, you can use it to fry your omelette without oil. Okay, next time I'm going to be doing that, to fry it without oil. Okay, so watch out for that. Maybe next week you'll be seeing that omelette. Let's see how it will turn out. Okay. Thank you so much for watching. If you have been able to watch up to this, thank you so much. I appreciate you all. This is how the omelette looks like, okay, after finishing. This is how it looks like. So delicious, so healthy, okay? You can call it vegetable fry cake. That's just by the way, fam. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, share my videos, like, interact in the comment section. God bless you. I'll see you again. Bye for now.